The VX1000 occupies the debug port of your ECU and you're tired of switching between the VX1000 and debug hardware? Let's learn more about software debugging over XCP. Hello and welcome to the VX1000 Tech Tutorials, where you will find technical tips and guidelines for our product. My name is Jonas, and today we are going to explore the functionality of software debugging over XCP. With me is my colleague Achim, who will guide us through all the details.
Thank you for the introduction, Jonas. Have you ever faced a situation where your VX1000 hardware is connected to the debug port of your ECU, but you still need to perform debugging? Switching between the two is not a good solution and might be even impossible because the pod is mounted inside the vehicle's ECU and there is no possibility to connect your debugging hardware. To address this issue, the Association for Standardization of Automation and Measuring Systems, short ASEM, has released the software standard for debugging over XCP. With this standard, you can use your existing VX1000 hardware as a debugging interface in conjunction with your current debugging software. How does this work? Your debugging software sends commands over Ethernet to the VX1000 hardware, which then executes these low-level debug commands. The VX1000 hardware supports various debug protocols, including JTAG, SWD, and DAP for software debugging over XCP. Software debugging over XCP is included in the standard feature set of VX1000. You can choose the debugging software of your choice. The software may require buying a specific debugging license from a third-party vendor. The configuration to use this feature is very simple and depends on the debugging tool. Currently, three tools support the standard: Trace32, WinIDEA, and UDE. A detailed configuration for these tools is available in our knowledge base at vector.com/kb. Today, we want to focus on Trace32 by Lauterbach. Configuring Trace32 to use the VX1000 hardware as a debugging interface is easy. Simply open your existing T32 file and add the following commands. Open the existing CMM script from your project and add the following commands at the beginning of the script. You can find this info in your software's documentation. The command systemconfig xcpslave is used to specify the IP address and TCP port of your VX1000 hardware. You can find the IP address in the VXconfig tool. In measurement setups, the XCP master, such as Canopy, typically uses TCP port 5555. Therefore, for the VX1000 hardware, we use the secondary TCP port 5554. This setup allows us to measure and debug at the same time. Additionally, we recommend setting the XCP slave mode to 2. This configuration allows debugging even if the VX1000 driver is not installed inside the ECU. Now we can start our Lauterbach script and we can see the ECU access is successful. Woo! We can read out memory, we can stop the microcontroller, and we can even look at registers. Perfect.
Achim, thank you very much. In this video, we demonstrated how to use the VX1000 hardware with the Trace32 debugging software to debug the ECU. Subscribe to our Vector Tech Tutorial channel today and we will keep you updated. If you miss any VX1000 topics, please contact us.
Bye-bye.